All right, joining us for Hot Copy today, we have the University of the Philippines Chancellor, Michael Tan. Thank you for coming in. I'm glad you made it. I know you were stuck in traffic. Let's get straight to the point. I mean, that's just a very small portion of the series of interviews where Chairman Popoy de Vera actually mentions your name. In effect, he said that what you had just wanted was essentially for your recommendation for the Dean of Business of UP to be followed, and essentially that you're, well, in effect, just upset that your own recommendation wasn't followed. Why are you first against the appointment of Joel Tan Torres as Dean of UP College of Business?
I don't want to make it a personal thing, no? And in fact, the comments that are coming out of UP are not mine, no? I represent the university, and the complaints are against four political appointments, not just one.
Not just him.
Yes, a lot of the media reports focus on BSB because BSB's faculty has been very, very vocal and has protested.
So that's business, kasi virata yun. Then you have the NCPAG dean, that's one. And who are the two others?
Engineering and UP Pampanga.
Okay, go on.
But we won't go... I don't want to concentrate on the names first because...
Let's talk about the process.
Yes.
Okay. So Popoy de Vera says they followed the process.
Right.
You're saying they did not follow.
Yeah.
Okay. Where don't you agree? I mean, the process would seem clear.
Right. Okay. The processes are there. They are found in various administrative orders. They're found in the UP... The UP law of 2008, the UP charter of 2008.
So what is the role of the committee? Let's say you don't have enough time. You arrived late. So let's go first. What is the role of the search committee?
Okay, let me read from the UP charter. Now, the dean shall be selected by the board. Yes, the board will elect upon nomination of the president of the university and recommendation of the chancellor of the constituent university following a process of consultation with the constituents of the college based on standards and guidelines.
Okay, can I show this? All right, because this is where, this is the one that Popoy de Vera did, he did not mention this. Okay, so this is section 19. Can we focus it? Section 19 of what?
The
what
UP
is
charter.
This? So section 19 of the UP charter. So it says here, the dean shall be elected by the board, so they did.
So we accept
that's the recommendation. But it says, upon the nomination of the president of the university, who did the president of the university nominate for business?
That is what I do not know.
Okay.
Either.
And the recommendation of the chancellor, which is you. So who did you recommend, just to be upfront?
Okay. For the
for business.
We can stick with business na lang.
Yeah, business muna.
For business, it was, I mentioned that the choice of the committee was Dr. Lorna Paredes, who is one of their faculty members. And then I said the board might want to consider si Gina Lizares.
Oh, so technically, you suggested two.
I gave two.
You recommended two names. You did not recommend one. Okay, so let's focus on section 19. So it has to be technically here that the board should choose from the recommendation of the chancellor and the nomination of the president.
I would like to think that.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Following a process of consultation with the constituents of the college. So can the board choose from the raw list of the committee? Because the committee had five names for business.
Yes.
Is the board, under the rules, allowed to choose from the five names?
Okay.
Or can they only choose technically? So my committee, five names. You've filtered it into two.
Right.
The president chooses one. Or can they only choose from you and the president?
Okay. Let's put it this way. The guidelines for the search committee, the search process, no, are found in many administrative orders and BOR resolutions. No? And this goes back from to 1976 under very, very progressive and forward-looking university presidents who have made this process one of the most democratic you'll ever think. That That applies actually for department chairs all the way up to the search committee is mandated with reviewing the qualifications of these candidates.
Of nominations.
Yes.
Okay.
And it is very clear that academic merit is the most important in here. Uh-huh. And that's understandable because we are
university. Let's stick to it. Mm-mm. If Joel Tan Torres was not qualified, did the search committee have the power to disqualify him?
No.
No.
Neither do I.
And neither do
yes.
you. So what you're mm-hmm. saying is the search committee just serves as what?
They are the initial screening. Mm-hmm. They, in fact, cannot even recommend a particular. Mm-hmm. They can hint at it because they put the strengths and weaknesses. It was very clear for VSB they wanted Dr. Lorna Paredes. Mm-hmm. But they were also, they gave very good reviews of Dr. Lizares. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I feel that the search committee and the chancellor, because we work closely together, we have to look mainly at the academic qualifications and leadership potential.
So that's the process. The search committee accepts nominations.
Yes.
They write the pros and cons, mm-hmm. but they don't make recommendations.
No.
They're not allowed.
They're not allowed.
There's no such thing as a short list.
No such thing as a
short
list.
So only you and the president, you're the next layer, you mm-hmm. can choose. You recommend.
Yes, we recommend. Mm-hmm.
So the board has to choose from what you and the president has recommended.
Preferably.
Based on Section 19. So is it mm-hmm. is it preferably or is that the rule?
The language can be interpreted according to, it depends on how they interpret it. My interpretation is that they should not, but I will say here also.
No, what do you mean they should not what?
Because they should listen to the president and the chancellor.
But, the reason, Mike, I'm asking mm-hmm. you this is because if it is not clear from your end, mm-hmm. then Popoy De Vera's argument will hold true in the sense that what he's saying is they got five names mm-hmm. and no one was disqualified in the five names. Mm-hmm. There's no such thing as a top three. Mm-hmm. Was there a top three?
No.
There's none.
No.
So you're essentially fighting it out on Section 19.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So should the board have chosen based on Section 19 the recommendation mm-hmm. of the chancellor and the nomination mm-hmm. of the president only?
Okay. Because this is not the only guideline. Mm-hmm. No, we have all those administrative orders of previous uh-oh. Presidents and the BOR's own resolutions.
Uh-oh.
And given that the dean is an academic leader, I would have liked them to choose someone who's academically qualified. Now, I will say here also, no, in the past few months, they have chosen at least four times someone who was not my recommendation. Mm-mm. And I have accepted it because I felt the four, pwede na ang academic qualifications.
Uh-oh.
They could be better, but pwede na yung apat. No?
Uh-oh.
Here, the reason there is so much protest right now is because the feeling is in the four academic institutions, the other candidates were much more qualified academically.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what happens now? Because you don't want it to be a personal issue
yes.
against the candidates. Mm-hmm. Where do you go now? Because at one point, you did accept some of the deans appointed
yes.
in the past that you didn't really recommend.
Mm-hmm.
So then you have a gray area here.
Mm-hmm.
So now, who can break the impasse?
Mm-hmm.
Does UP accept, for example, Joel Tan Torres as the dean?
Mm-hmm.
Or now will the faculty go up in arms and say, we won't accept him?
Mm-hmm.
What
mm-hmm.
happens now?
Okay. What has happened is I have told the colleges concerned we have to live with the appointments for now, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because for the welfare of the students, we cannot afford to have a vacuum. No? But I said we will be very vigilant in watching these four. We will guide them because I tell you, they are just so clueless sometimes with administrative tasks. My work has become so much heavier because I'm constantly having to correct them. I'm constantly having to tell them this is the thing you have to do, okay? But in the meantime, we have asked the Board of Regents to explain to us what did they see in these four that the search committee did not and that I did not.
Uh-oh.
So
but
hinihintay namin.
How can that
nila.
Solve, I mean, essentially the issue from repeating itself because Popoy De Vera already explained, well, his explanation is Joel Tan Torres was the top notcher in the CPA board exams. He served in the Bureau of Internal Revenue, served in the PRC. He's an outstanding alumni. The college, this is an exact soundbite. The college awarded him outstanding alumni. They think he's good enough to be outstanding alumni, but not good enough to be their dean. That's hypocritical.
Mm-hmm.
And he also said the rules don't require candidates to have a PhD or to be faculty members. So, why then do you feel, based on this argument, that he wouldn't be qualified?
Because I'm looking at the other four. Even I recommended
so
two,
why
even
do,
the other
why
two.
Why do you think was he chosen?
You know, I cannot read their minds, although I hear things. I would prefer, let's give the Board of Regents, let's give the ones who voted for Joel Tan Torres a chance to explain why they voted for this guy. No? Because remember, it was a 6-5 vote.
Yeah.
So the five, it's self-explanatory. The six, we need to hear from them. That is what Virata School of Business is also asking.
No?
I have to say also in the Virata School of Business, something like 36 faculty out of 43 have signed a statement saying that they do not accept this dean. See what I'm facing
right now?
Wait,
so what you're saying is 36 members?
Faculty members.
Yeah, faculty members of the College of Business in UP, Diliman.
Yes.
Have signed
a statement.
A statement that they don't accept the dean.
Yes.
Okay, now I know you've spoken to them, but technically, what should happen next? Because it does not make good also for the credibility of the College of Business if you have 36, how many faculty members
out of 43.
Are there? So that's more than, that's a majority.
Big majority.
That's like 80%, even more.
And so, all five professors emeriti, meaning these are the kagalang-galang.
So what happens to them now? Mm-hmm. What do you do with that statement?
This is again,
do
all
they go
that we're
to the Board of Regents?
Yes, they have asked the Board of Regents to clarify their appointment, and it's been almost 2 weeks. We have not heard anything from them.
Uh-oh.
And so this is the very simple, and we're just asking, please explain your choices. Yan lang hinihingi namin, no? For the sake of UP and the processes.
Okay, but let's say they explain and the board and the faculty members of business still don't agree. What happens after?
We will have to keep the dialogue continuing. The faculty is committed to continue to serve the students, to continue to teach, and I'm happy about that. No? But to all four, we are watching. No? Let's not quibble kasi on certain things, what is actually said there. For instance, with the College of Engineering, we would have preferred a dean who has a license to practice engineering.
What do you mean? Your dean doesn't have a license?
He does not.
Yeah, well... So I think the problem with UP now, if you ask me, is the requirements to be dean, and forgive me, I don't want any, I'm from UP, is your requirements aren't,
alumni.
Your requirements aren't tight.
It's because we recognize that different colleges will have different requirements, different needs, okay?
I agree.
College of Fine Arts, ang hirap maghanap ng PhD, and we'll live with that, no? Because it's very rare that artists will go on for a PhD. That's fine. We cannot require them to have a license because there's no licensure for artists, right?
No, but then per college, why doesn't UP make specific requirements so you don't have this problem after?
Yeah, so we do ask the search committees if they want to add requirements. So they have that option.
You are part of the search committee, no?
No, I have to keep my
hands off. So can the search committee make their own requirements? Because what's hard, they can't recommend, they can't even disqualify. So they can just tighten requirements?
They can add certain requirements like a PhD, which the Virata School of Business wanted to do. But then that was also debated because, again, a PhD is not very common with business administration, again.
No, that's not common.
Yeah.
Okay.
But all four had them. All four candidates.
Yeah. No, but then my take is if you want to be dean, I mean, you'd have to be exceptional in terms of your, you know...
Academic
requirements and achievements.
Yes.
So, wait, just very quickly, the College of Engineering, so you now have a dean with no engineering license.
Yes.
And how does this affect the credibility with the students?
The students don't know what to do at this point. Let me say that I get into very tight situations when I meet other university presidents and officials. You know, they give me that look na, anong nangyayari sa UP?
Yeah.
And
okay, the faculty also of engineering sign a statement?
No.
Why not?
That again, we will have to ask the College of Engineering.
So, I mean, there are technically four, but let's not go into the four. In terms just of processes in UP, if you have 36 or 43 faculty members in business who are against the new dean, what rights do the faculty members have?
Well, they have the right to issue that statement.
They did.
Yes.
But then can they remove an appointed dean? Can they rally and protest against an appointed dean? I'm just curious how far UP rights go. Can they say, we won't go to work unless the dean is changed?
They could, but I hope they will not.
Okay.
I think we have agreed that business must continue at the College of Business Administration. It keeps going back there that there are many things which are not explicitly stated, and we could argue forever about what is in there and what is not. But we're talking here about the moral grounds. The faculty are really in a dilemma. Maybe just a quick story. One of the young faculty members who is an official of that college came to me yesterday to resign. I have never seen such disillusionment in such a young faculty member. I said, can you keep it a few days? Yeah. Hindi na daw niya kaya.
What college?
This business administration.
Okay.
You see? And this is the type of thing I have to deal with all the time. The last few weeks na. Puro mga reklamo. And I say, you have to come out in the open and speak about it. And
well,
then
they
get all the blame.
I was going to say, I want you to react because Chairman Popoy de Veras mentioned your name many times on the show. And technically, he's made it about you.
Yes.
So just to contextualize, essentially, he said that, in effect, these are my words, you were acting spoiled that just because your recommendations weren't chosen.
Oh, my.
Yeah. So it comes out to a very personal, discretionary feel instead of a whole process issue and qualifications issue.
Right. And I hope I've made it clear, it is a process issue. And I have accepted in the past four of their recommendations that were not mine, but because, and I accepted only because those other four, I felt were at least medyo decent na academic qualifications. But with these four, there are just too many questions. And it becomes very tiring to have to hold their hands in some way. I'm not literally, but hand holding.
Okay. Now we have 2 minutes to go, and I could have given you the whole show, Michael. You know that.
I know. Thank you.
So UP is the premier university in the country. I mean, this wouldn't happen hypothetically. Let's say abroad, you won't hear this in Harvard or in Yale or whatever. Clearly, the bigger issue is, we can't have the Board of Regents, who are appointed politically, to make the choices for UP alone.
Yes.
I think that's the lesson, right? You can't have a dean on a 6-5 vote. And then you have most of those in the Board of Regents. They've been appointed by a sitting president, etc. Or they may have ties to politicians. What is the best way? How can you tighten now regulations and requirements and make sure that, frankly, UP gets the best deans and the best faculty?
Precisely,
How? What can you do?
The UP president has offered to mediate, and I have said, yes, please come in. This is not a battle between UP Diliman and the Board of Regents, because there are good men and one woman in the Board of Regents. I hope that I do see weaknesses in the existing rules. I would like more say on the part of colleges. That it shouldn't be all the chancellor.
I agree that the colleges have, because they work with the dean.
And ultimately, everything boils down to academic merit plus plus. And I just wanted to say the plus plus there. A political appointee goes in because of power play.
Yeah.
I want to see a dean who goes in because he truly loves, he or she loves the students, loves teaching, loves research. And that is always in the back of my mind when I make these recommendations.
Would you prefer a dean that's had experience in teaching first? Would that be a requirement that you want?
I think it is very, very important.
That before you become dean, you've taught first.
Mm-hmm. Because the academic environment is so different from a corporation, from the outside. No? Mm-hmm. Now, those things are helpful. That's why I recommended Gina Lizares, because she has worked with McKinsey and other top-notch firms. Mm-hmm. But she is also a teacher, no? With a good track record. Mm-hmm. So I look at the scores that they have in teaching evaluation. All of that should go into the big picture.
Ma-a. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.